cranial nerves emerge directly from the brain. Unlike spinal nerves in the spinal cord's domain, the first two cranial nerves arise from the cerebrum, while the other 10 nerves arise from the brainstem. Your special senses are olfaction, audition, vision, balance, gustation, detected by specialized organs which collect this information. Your general senses are temperature, vibration, pressure, touch, and pain, detected over a widespread area and sent to your brain. Cranial nerve 1, the olfactory, helps you detect smells, transmitting signals that come from olfactory epithelium cells. The second, the optic nerve, transmits retinal input. This nerve allows you to see. So here it is, come look. Pupils are constricted by the third nerve, the oculomotor, also running for eye muscles. It's the eyeball's main motor. It talks to the Edinger Westphal and oculomotor nuclei to help lens accommodation and lift the upper lid of your eye. The fourth, the trochlear nerve, on the trochlear nucleus relies in order to control the superior oblique muscles of your eyes. The fifth, the trigeminal, the largest of the cranial nerves, controlling mastication muscles for chewing food it serves, and senses temperature, touch, and pain of your scalp, face, meninges, larynx, pharynx, sinuses, and oral and nasal cavities. The sixth, the abducens nerve, on the abducens nucleus relies to innervate the lateral rectus muscles of your eyes. The seventh, the facial nerve, feels touch behind your ear and controls facial expressions like happiness or fear, to transmitting taste from the front. Two-thirds of the tongue is devoted and has secretomotor function for all head glands except the parotid. The eighth, the vestibulocochlear, this nerve has two talons, linking the semicircular canals to the vestibular nucleus for balance and sending sound signals from cochlea to cochlear nucleus. So it talks with two nuclei, as you'll remember if you're studious. The ninth, the glossopharyngeal nerve, takes over the parotid gland, transmitting taste from the back third of the tongue so food isn't bland. It gives sensation to your tongue, tonsils, pharynx, and eardrum too. Innervates the stylopharyngeous muscle, measures blood pressure, pH O2. The tenth, the vagus nerve, has so many functions, from thoracic and abdominal organs. It gets visceral sensations. It also gives sensation to your external ear and to your meninges, lower pharynx and larynx here. It innervates palate muscles and the larynx and the pharynx, causes gland secretion in the thorax, abdomen, larynx, pharynx. The 11th, the accessory nerve, for motor use is employed, innervating the upper trapezius and sternocleidomastoid. The 12th, the hypoglossal nerve, has motor function solely and innervates extrinsic and intrinsic tongue muscles totally, except for the palatoglossus, which elevates the tongue's back part